Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off today's video, SpaceX launched another Starlink mission during the last week with Starlink 4-9. The booster which launched this mission, B1060, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship Just Read the Instructions.
26th overall landing on Just Read the Instructions. You can see a shot there. We also had a call out.
Nominal orbit insertion.
Two call outs there on the second stage, confirmation of second engine cutoff and a nominal orbit, which means those Starlink satellites are right where they want to be for the upcoming payload deployment.
SpaceX posted a tweet about this launch saying this was our 9th Falcon 9 launch in the first 9 weeks of 2022. In addition to that launch, there's another Falcon 9 launch coming up this week with more Starlink satellites. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 4-10 mission is expected to lift off on Tuesday 8th at 2:06 PM UTC or 9:06 AM Eastern Time. There was a tweet posted with some information on Starlink changes from Elon Musk in response to the Starlink terminal sent to Ukraine. He said, "Updating software to reduce peak power consumption so Starlink can be powered from car cigarette lighter. Mobile roaming enabled so phased array antenna can maintain signal while on moving vehicle." Musk posted another tweet related to Ukraine saying, "Important warning, Starlink is the only non-Russian communication system still working in some parts of Ukraine, so probability of being targeted is high. Please use with caution." There was also another tweet posted saying, "Starlink has been told by some governments, not Ukraine, to block Russian news sources. We will not do so unless at gunpoint. Sorry to be a free speech absolutist." Another tweet posted says, "SpaceX reprioritised to cyber defence and overcoming signal jamming will cause slight delays in Starship and Starlink V2. Musk was asked, "Are Starlink satellites being jammed?" He responded and said, "Some Starlink terminals near conflict areas were being jammed for several hours at a time. Our latest software update bypasses the jamming. I'm curious to see what's next." Then he posted another tweet saying, "In a way, this is free QA." Eric Berger posted a series of tweets related to the next Dragon Crew and SpaceX's next commercial crew launch, Crew 4. The first tweet says, "ESA announced this week that Crew 4 will be a shorter mission to the International Space Station and Samantha Cristoforetti will no longer serve as commander because of the shorter on-orbit increment. I'd like to explain why so this is not misunderstood." Next, he posted, "This is not a reflection of Samantha, whom just about everyone I've spoken to says is awesome. And my personal interactions with her have been great as well. This does seem to be purely a scheduling issue." He also posted saying, "This is about giving NASA and ESA maximum flexibility in ensuring a direct handover between Crew 4 and Crew 5 this fall to ensure there is no gap in which there is no US astronaut on board. This puts the NASA handover before the Soyuz handover this fall." Finally, his last tweet said, "This change was in the works before the Russian invasion of Ukraine, so it was not done in response to that. Although escalating tensions certainly make the move seem prudent. Basically, this ensures NASA and ESA people will be on the station even if there is no Soyuz seat swap." To avoid confusion, there was another tweet posted by someone saying, "I'm confused. She's no longer part of Crew 4? Are they only flying with three astronauts or has she been replaced?" Eric Berger responded with, "The details are in the release. She is still part of Crew 4, but their increment will no longer be long enough for her to serve as commander for a few months." Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Upgrades are going on with the suborbital Pad A launch mount for future prototypes. The construction of the new wide bay in the production yard is continuing. The crane parts recently delivered are being used to extend a crane in the yard. This crane has since been raised. There is work going on near the Starbase sign. There was a great aerial photo posted on Twitter by RGV Aerial Photography of the production yard. It says, "Groundbreaking of Phase 1 of Star Factory at Starbase. Building is expected to be over 300,000 square foot by 60 foot tall and will replace all the large production tents. Building will extend almost to fence of Highway 4. There was another tweet posted with Starship infrastructure work going on at Roberts Road near Kennedy Space Center. As you know, SpaceX are well underway with their work to build a Starship launch site at the Cape. In these photos, you can see there is a newly constructed tank over there. They've also started working on the base of a few of the launch integration tower segments, which are identical to what they built in Boca Chica. This aft ring stack was sleeved with the super heavy aft dome sitting out in the yard. On the left here is a Starship aft dome with a new design. This booster upper stack was seen outside near the high bay. Over the last week, SpaceX did some testing with another Starship 20 cryogenic proof test. Crews have been seen working on Starship 22's body flaps. SpaceX also completed yet another cryogenic proof test of the Booster 4 prototype. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, once again there was some testing this last week. For this coming week, there are also more closures scheduled with Monday 7th, Tuesday 8th and Wednesday 9th. These white grid fins for Super Heavy Booster 7 were spotted sitting outside. This new design for the Booster 7 aft section was rolled out of a tent. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, and Nick Antuini for being out there in Boca Chica filming the content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.